Mr. Speaker, from 1932 to 1933, the Stalin regime deliberately induced a famine that killed an estimated 7 million Ukrainians. This regime sentenced Ukrainians to a horrifying slow death by starvation in an attempt to destroy their hopes for a free and independent Ukraine. One of the difficult things about the Holodomor is the question, why didn't people know of this outside of Ukraine? Well, how is it today we really do not know what is happening inside Syria today? How is it we couldn't confirm Hitler's murderous acts? My father lived in Ukraine during this period. I asked him many times. He did not know. He lived in that part of the Ukraine controlled by Poland. Stalin and his regime not only murdered, but they covered up. The horror has left a deep scar in the Ukrainian community throughout the world, including here in Manitoba, where many survivors and their descendants, some survivors here today, have made their home. To honor the memory of those we lost, we mark the fourth Saturday of November as Holodomor Ukrainian Famine and Genocide Memorial Day. November 23rd to 29 is also National Holodomor Awareness Week. I encourage Manitobans to take in some of the events over the next several days and tell the story of the Holodomor. Listen to a presentation at the University of Manitoba. Visit the new Canadian Museum for Human Rights and find the gallery on level 4 called Breaking the Silence. Attend a memorial service. Visit the monument, Mother and Child, at Winnipeg City Hall. Or visit the monument, Bitter Memories of Childhood, on the west side of the legislature. Joining us in the gallery are members from the Holodomor Awareness Committee of the Ukrainian Canadian Congress, who have all presented members of the legislature kindly with a book about the Holodomor. Thank you to the UCC and the League of Ukrainian Canadians for making sure that the stories of the Holodomor are told. We promise to never forget those who suffered from this tragedy. Events in the world tragically repeat themselves. This has been the sad story of the people of Ukraine. Yet in the remembrance of this tragic event, and more important, through the spirit and unrelenting resolve of the Ukrainian people, a new Ukraine has emerged. In modern Ukraine, where as we speak, the Ukrainian people strive to preserve democracy, we join them. We join them through our remembrance of the past and hope for a truly free, united Ukraine as we go forward. We who are blessed to live on the banks of the Red and the Assiniboine share our remembrance, faith, hope, and dreams with those on the banks of the Dnipro. Vichnaya Panya.